Yes, dear students, on the basis of origin, we divide resources into two parts, biotic and abiotic. Biotic resources, they are obtained from the biosphere and have life. For example, human beings, flora and fauna. They are biotic resources. Second one is abiotic resources. They are the mixture of or compound of non-living things that are known as abiotic resources and have not life. For example, rocks, minerals, lakes, these are all abiotic resources. Now, second one, on the basis of exhaustibility, we divide resources into, again, two parts. First is renewable resources, and second is non-renewable resources. Renewable resources which can be renewed or reproduced, they are known as renewable resources. These resources are renewed by chemical, physical or mechanical process. For example, solar energy, wind energy, they are known as renewable resources. We use again and again. And non-renewable resources, these resources take a million of years in the process of formation, and these occur over a long geological time to renew. They are known as non-renewable resources, like minerals, fossil fuels, petrol, oil. These are known as the non-renewable resources. Next is, on the basis of ownership, we divide resources into four parts. Yes, on the basis of ownership, we divided resources into four types. These are, first is individual resources, second, community resources, national resources, and international. Yes, on the basis of ownership, we divided resources into four types. First is individual resources, second, community resources, third, national, and last, international resources. Yes, first is individual resources, the resources which are owned by individuals, like houses, plots, shops. These are known as individual resources. Second, community resources, the resources which belong to any community or yes, on the basis of ownership, individual, community, national and international resources. First of all, individual resources, the resources which are owned by individuals, like houses, plots, shops, they are known as individual resources. Second, community resources, these are the resources which are accessible to all the members of the community. That is known as community resources, like grazing grounds, playgrounds, picnic spots, they are community resources. Next, national resources, technically all the resources belong to the nation. They are known as national resources, like forest, minerals, they are known as national resources owned by particular or individual nation. And last is international resources. These are international resources. There are international institutions which regulate some resources. Like India has got the right to mine manganese from the Indian Ocean, from that area which lies beyond the exclusive zone. These are international resources. Now, last is status of development. This topic we will discuss tomorrow. Thanks. Have a... Yes, last is your status of development. We will discuss tomorrow. I hope students, you understand all these topics very well. I just review all these topics again on the basis of origin, biotic, abiotic, exhaustibility, renewable and non-renewable, and on the basis of ownership, they are divided into individual, community, national and international. Now, discuss. Yes, and the last is your status of development. Students, we will discuss this topic tomorrow. I hope you understand all the topics very well. I review these topics again on the basis of origin, biotic, abiotic, exhaustibility, renewable, non-renewable, and on the basis of ownership, individual, community resources, national and international resources. Revise all the topics at home. Meet you again. Thanks. Be safe. Stay at home.